So we bring you our third team of challengers.
What is your name, please?
My name is Arthur Fromer.
My name is Arthur Fromer.
My name is Arthur Fromer.
Again, panel, may I ask you to follow along with your copies of this affidavit. I, Arthur Fromer, am the author of America's largest selling travel book. It is called Europe on $5 a Day. And in it, I list and discuss comfortable but reasonable hotels, inexpensive restaurants, and budget shopping bargains. The book contains a few fundamental rules for economy touring abroad and is designed to dispel the notion that European travel has to cost a small fortune. As a matter of fact, for each of the 17 cities covered, I make suggestions which can cut a person's outlay to $4 or even $3 a day, including both room and meals. Signed, Arthur Fromer. This time, panel, we bring you three gentlemen, each one claiming to be the same one, namely Arthur Fromer, author of America's best-selling travel book. So let's start this round with our world traveler, Sam Levenson. Sam?
Well, willing to start tonight. Number two, what is the value of the French mark today?
I never heard of it.
I'm sorry. I mean the German mark. The German mark today.
They're approximately four to a dollar.
Four to a dollar. How about the... I'll stay with number two for a minute. How about the Spanish peso? How much is that worth in American money?
It's the peseta. 59.8 exactly in New York.
Boy.
Right. And how much is... What is the British pound today?
$2.80.
Uh-huh. Number two, what would be an inexpensive trip to France by air alone for me? Number three.
Number three?
Number three, yeah.
The regular jet fare is... $530
round trip.
Kitty.
Number one, I'm delighted to talk to you because I intend to go to Europe and I'd like to know how to do it on $3 or $4 or $5 a day. Where does the train bleu start and where does it go, the blue train?
It runs from Paris to Madrid.
Number three, where does the Oriental Express go?
Starts from Paris and ends in Vienna.
Number three, what is the capital of Belgrade? I mean, what is the capital of... let's say it differently. What's the capital of Bulgaria? Yeah. Number
Rijeka.
Two.
Rijeka.
Huh? Oh, number two.
I'm capital sorry, Bulgaria. I don't know.
Capital
don't
of Bulgaria. Do you know the capital of Bulgaria, number three?
I'm sorry, I don't.
You don't. Number one, you don't know either?
No, I don't.
That's interesting.
Tom.
Nobody goes there.
Gee, I'd like to know myself. I'd like to know how to live on $5 a day in America. Yeah. If any of you guys want to get smart, you write a book like that. Number three, what about Paris? Can you get by with $5 a day in Paris?
I think you can get by easily in Paris. The left bank of Paris has very many moderately priced hotels and restaurants.
Thank you. Number one, where is Juin-les-Pins?
On the Riviera.
Whereabouts, you know?
West of Cannes and Nice.
Thank you. Number two, what is the Grand Corniche and the Moyen Corniche? I bet you know.
Yes, I do. Do you want me to answer?
Yeah. He knows everything. What else do you know?
Peggy.
Thank you. Number one, there is another way to go by air that you can save money, another airline. Which airline is that?
Icelandic.
Thank you. Number two, what is the British railroads give you a bargain thing. Would you explain that to me in one sentence?
It's cheaper if you buy what amounts to a season ticket. You can do the same thing for all the European railways with the Eurail Pass.
Thank you. Number three, what is a parador?
A parador is a government-sponsored castle in Spain.
Thank you. There's one in the north of Spain, number one. Would you please tell me what it is? It's near Santander.
I'm not familiar with that one.
Number two, do you know?
Estanzione.
Right, that's all the time we have, unfortunately. You're going to have to mark your ballots at once. Without change and without consultation, of course, as you vote now for number one, number two, or number three. All voting ended?
No contest.
All ballots marked. Tom, which one did you select this time?
Well, I had a vote for number two. Even if he isn't the right one, look how smart he is. My gosh, he knew everything. Unless those things were not true, I bet he did know what the Grand and the Moyen Corniche were, too. I know he did.
Well, I don't think it was number two because that wasn't the right answer to the last one I asked.
What did you want to ask?
I forget now. But I voted for number three because I thought he knew an awful lot, but number one knows too. Yes, but anyway, I went with three.
They all know.
All right, Sam Levenson.
This Robin Hood here. I was very much impressed by number two, who even corrected me when I threw him peso. He changed it to peseta, which is pretty close.
And you taught Spanish, didn't you?
Yeah.
Kitty.
Well, I felt one had to vote for number two. However, I must say quickly, I'd go to Europe with any of the three of them because they really know what they're talking about.
All right, there we go again. This time.
I said that the Oriental Express went to Vienna and it goes all the way to Constantinople, I think.
Oh, next, then it's got to be one.
Okay.
He wants a change of vote.
Three for two and one for three. You're closer to unanimity than you have at any time been tonight, have been at any time tonight. So let's find out immediately, without any further delay, which one of these gentlemen actually is the author of the best-selling travel book in America. Will the real Arthur Frommer please stand up?
Oh, my God!
It what?
You have to change in Vienna because you need a visa to keep going all the way through Bulgaria.
Oh, that's the limit is to be there. Number one, what is your real name, sir? What do you really do?
My name is Joe Wetzel. I work for the Ivel Corporation Exhibit Designers.
Thank you, sir. Huh? Well, number two, what is your real name and what do you really do?
My name is George Clark. I'm a resident in surgery at Mount Sinai Hospital, and I've never been to Europe.
Can say is that much knowledge about other things, you must be a pretty darn good surgeon. I'd be very content under your care, I'm sure. Very well, the score shows this time you got the highest for tonight. There were three incorrect. And at $250 each, that not only gives a nice fat total, but a very easy divide between the two of you. Three of you, I should say. That's $750, of course. And thank you for bringing us such a very nice and active and exciting round. That comes to you, of course, from Salem Cigarettes, as does a carton of Salem's on your way out. Thank you, gentlemen, for being with us. Good night. Hope you enjoyed yourselves. God bless you. Well, I guess that's it for tonight. May I remind you once again, please, that Radio Free Europe's daily broadcasts bring hope for the future to some 80 million once free men and women behind the Iron Curtain now. So support Radio Free Europe, please. Final announcements. Peggy Cass got all three right tonight. So good night, panel. Don't forget to join us again next week at the same time, and I'll see you tomorrow afternoon on our daytime show. And in the meantime, speaking for Salem Cigarettes, may I remind you to tell the truth. Good night.
To Tell the Truth is a Mark Goodson, Bill Cotman production. Brought to you tonight by Salem, the cigarette that refreshes your taste. Donnie Olson speaking for To Tell the Truth, this program was pre-recorded.